Hey, I'm Gordie Johnson of Big Sugar, and you're watching Long McQuade Facebook Live Music Clinic. And today I'm going to tell you about some different ways you can tune your guitar, besides just your regular standard tuning. There are a lot of ways that I have used over the span of my career, use different tunings, altered tunings, to make playing songs easier, give chords a certain color and definition, and it can really accentuate the personality of a song using some different guitar tunings. So we'll get right into it here. And one of the ones I'm going to show you, which is one of my favorite ones to use, and it's very simple to, if it's going to be your first time using an altered tuning, I strongly recommend this one. It's a drop D tuning, if you've never heard of it. So you play yourself a big old D chord. Let me just clean that up a bit. It's a regular cowboy chord. And then tune that E string down to the D. And that gives you an instant power chord. Every time you just put your finger, you know, you used to see in a power chord like look like that, right, guitar players? What I'm talking about is getting the benefits of a power chord with just putting one finger down. Everything else stays the same except for that low D. That enables you to play your regular kind of pentatonic guitar shapes, those regular little boxes you play solos with. But you have the benefit of that low tuning of that chunky low D. Sounds great for heavy metal or any heavy music, but even for some of the reggae stuff and funkier stuff that we use, I like to use it because then I can focus more on the rhythm and less on fingerings. So why don't I show you an example of that? Let's play an old Big Sugar song called Turn the Lights On.
Pressing down on me, I
think you get the idea. So that's just one of the examples of how you get the benefit of just that single finger power chord, like that. I'm gonna show you another example on a song called Nicotina. Here we go. Now, change of guitar, change of vibes. I'm going to tell you about open G tuning, which is one that I enjoy using a lot. And I've even modified my open G tuning to accommodate chord voicings by making it an open G, usually an open G. You would go a low D, a G, a D, a G, B, a D. So some of your strings stay the same, as you can see from your standard tuning, like your B string, your G string, and your D string. Retain that triad sound. With that fifth on the bottom, give you some nice colors. But what I've done is I've lowered the bottom string so I've got a low C, which allows me to play songs like Roads Ahead is a Big Sugar song. So that puts my home key, if I want to play the lowest notes I've got, that puts my home key in the key of C. So a song that's in the key of C, you can see you get a very wide kind of chordal sound, and you also have the benefit of just playing that single finger down, covers that whole fret. And I'll demonstrate this for you on a song called Anything Is Possible from our new record, Eternity Now. I'll do that one for you. Check it out.
Thank you.
I will further demonstrate for you. Open G with a dropped C. In this case, I'm going to capo up so that the song gives me a C chord right there. But now the song's in the key of F in open G, cape it up to that fret. Let's see if we can figure this out. This one's called Wonder 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 Wonder. We can take that open G and we can take it to some extremes, as I've also done. And I'll just show you a little piece of an old folk piece that I used to play called Motherless Children, which starts out in open G, but to play the melody, I put that low string all the way down to G. And then my B string.
mother's dead. Motherless children have a hard time. Mother's dead. Motherless children have a hard time when the mother's dead. Father will do the best he can when your mother's dead. Father will do the best he can, mother's dead. Father will do the best he can. Some things your father can't understand. Nobody loves you like a mother can. Mother's dead. Mother's dead, Lord. Nobody else can take your mother's place. Mother's dead. Mother is dead, Lord. Nobody else can take your mother's place. Nobody else can take your mother's place.
That's definitely an example of the tuning accommodating the song and the key and allowing me to have no other musical accompaniment just by having that bass note. Having those two strings tuned the same way also gives you kind of that 12-string effect where you have, they're never going to be quite exactly in tune, two different string gauges, one at high tension, one at very loose tension. So that gives you that really, really rangy kind of sound to it. Okay, now we're bringing out the big guns. All right. The storied Alex Lifeson double neck. Now, in September of this year, we'll be putting out a special 25th anniversary package of Hemivision on vinyl and CD and for streaming with a bunch of additional material and photographs and cool archival stuff. Alex Lifeson wrote a little essay for us, and I wrote a piece about the history of the making of Hemivision. And Alex Lifeson laying this guitar on me really was the blasting cap that sent us rocketing in a whole different direction with what the record was fixing to sound like and what it ended up sounding like. Really would not have gone there, I think, without this guitar. And I will play you one of the first songs that we recorded with it. More open G, this time capoed up to the second fret, which makes us in the key of A. And I'll show you how we play Digging a Hole.
Crying for
All right. Through the magic of video editing, I will show you one song with two different approaches to the tuning. Here's a song that goes back to our Brothers and Sisters, Are You Ready record. And this is the title track, Brothers and Sisters, Are You Ready? And I'm going to play it in standard. Don't usually play it in standard. I usually play it in open G, but it's in the key of E. So it voices perfectly fine in standard tuning, which I'm going to try right now. Play a little bit, play some solo, monkey around a little bit. Let's see how we like that. And then partway through, I'll switch to open G and play it that way. So let's have a little demonstration of Red Rover Served Two Ways.
Yeah.
So that's just a little example of what you can do between those two tunings, play the same song. It just makes you think a whole different way. You know, here are the songs in the key of E. Here the song is in the key of E, but with that open G, it forces me to think in different ways and in different places, finding the relative minor of that G. Gives me a nice big power chord here, again with one finger playing that E. And I get the low fifth underneath each one of the chords, which certainly heavies the situation up a little bit. I've always loved that low fifth sound to a power chord. So that's how we end up having a song in the key of E, but ended up playing it in open G. It also gave us some nice chimey things happening in the verses. So those are just a few of the many altered tunings that we use, that we like to use. I'm Gordie Johnson here in the Sound Shack in the sweltering heat of Austin, Texas, and I'm happy to be a part of this Long McQuade presentation, guitar clinic. I used to travel all over Canada doing guitar clinics in every city. I bet I've been in every Long McQuade in Canada, so it gives me great pleasure to be able to do this for all y'all customers of Long McQuade's and to all the staff and my love and admiration for Jack Long himself, the founder, is very long-standing, and I will never forget how kind he was to me in my younger days when I was having trouble keeping my account up to date. I do recall living at the Cameron House on Queen Street in Toronto and being dirt poor and owing Long McQuade a lot of money for some rentals, and got a call from Jack Long himself. And I'll never forget, he said to me, you know, I hear you're a pretty good jazz guitar player. And at the time, I was pretty good at it. And I said, yes, sir, that's how I aim to pay off my account, which is in arrears. And he said, well, I'll tell you what, how about you come in the store a couple of Saturdays? If you'll sit in the corner and play jazz standards so we don't have to hear Stairway to Heaven all afternoon, that would be nice to have that kind of music in the store for a while. So I did that for about a month of Saturdays. I went to Long McQuade on Bloor Street and played Moon Glow and Stormy Weather, any songs I thought he would know, and managed to pay off my sizable debt by just playing some jazz guitar in the corner. So, you know, my heart belongs to Long McQuade. I'm Gordie Johnson.